Okay, good afternoon, everyone. So in the last class, we had discussed about the topic bleaching powder, right? Bleaching powder. And Gautam, can you tell me the chemical formula of this bleaching powder?
Ma.
Tell me.
CA. CaOH2.
CaO.
H.
That's the formation, right? What about the chemical formula of bleaching powder? What's the product form there?
CaO. Cl2.
Yeah, that's it. CaO, Cl2. That's the chemical formula of bleaching powder. Then what about the uses of bleaching powder, Shania? Can you tell me one use?
For bleaching cotton and linen textiles. Yes.
Then? Elsa, can you tell me one?
Ma'am, it is an oxidizing agent in many industries.
Yeah, many chemical industries. Gauri?
Ma'am.
Yeah. Yes.
Ma'am, I was saying the answer. I'm going to say the answer. The uses of bleaching powder.
Elsa, yes. Then what about the other one? Gauri, can you tell me?
For disinfecting drinking water and make it free from germs.
Then how can we produce this bleaching powder? Elena, can you tell me?
Like calcium hydroxide and chlorine.
Yeah, calcium hydroxide reacts with chlorine to form this bleaching powder. And the chemical formula of this bleaching powder, it is CaOCl2. Okay, then what about the uses of chlorine? Karthik, uses of chlorine.
When it's used in powder packaging.
Which one?
Bleaching powder or chlorine?
Chlorine.
Ma'am. Chlorine is used in water treatment.
Then?
CFS.
CFC.
PVC.
Yes. Okay, that's enough. Okay, fine. Then, Eva, can you tell me the uses of hydrogen? Okay, it's okay. You're traveling. It's okay. Kisan, you can tell me the uses of hydrogen.
I'm decreasing the metal removing the metal, decrease the metal surfaces.
That's the use of sodium hydroxide. What about hydrogen? Hydrogen.
Hydrogen. And that is now I said no, that is no, that is sodium.
No. That's sodium hydroxide.
Then.
And it burns vigorously.
Fuel.
Which one, Mohammed?
Ma'am. Margarine used for.
Margarine
used for the.
Yeah, hydrogen is used for the manufacture of margarine. Then.
Then. Fuel.
Fuel. Then ammonia for fertilizers.
Fertilizers.
Okay. Mohammed Nihal, can you tell me the uses of sodium hydroxide? Please mute.
NH3.
Okay, ammonia. It's NH3. Mohammed Nihal, can you tell me the uses of sodium hydroxide? Unmute. Yes. Raya, can you tell me the uses of sodium hydroxide?
It is used in soaps and detergent.
Then?
Paper making.
Huh?
Paper making.
Okay, then?
Artificial fibers and degreasing method.
Okay, then today we are going to learn about another chemical from this common salt. It is known as baking soda. Okay, it is known as baking soda. Baking soda. So this is the chemical formula of baking soda. NaHCO3. Okay, NaHCO3. It is known as sodium hydrogen carbonate. Sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, sodium hydrogen carbonate. NaOH is known as caustic soda. Then CaOCl2, it is known as bleaching powder. This one, NaHCO3, it is known as sodium hydrogen carbonate baking soda. Clear? So this is the third chemical that obtained from sodium chloride. Okay? Baking soda. Sodium hydrogen carbonate. NaHCO3. It is produced on a large scale by treating cold and concentrated solution of sodium chloride, the same one, brine, with ammonia and carbon dioxide. So we have learned all these chemicals are obtained from the sodium chloride, right? So in the production of this baking soda, this sodium chloride or the brine solution, this react with ammonia and carbon dioxide. Ammonia and carbon dioxide. So this is the chemical reaction take place first. Sodium chloride, NaCl, then plus H2O, at the presence of water is there. Okay, it reacts with carbon dioxide, CO2. You can write CO2. Okay. CO2, then NH3. It is ammonia to form NH4Cl and NaHCO3. Can you tell me the name of this compound NH4Cl?
Sodium chloride plus
I'm asking about NH4Cl. Yes, it is known as ammonium chloride.
Ammonium chloride.
Okay, ammonium chloride. So this baking soda, sodium hydrogen carbonate or otherwise NaHCO3, it's also prepared from this sodium chloride. It is otherwise known as brine solution. Okay. This brine solution, it reacts with carbon dioxide and ammonia in the presence of water to form sodium hydrogen carbonate. That's the baking soda along with ammonium chloride, NH4Cl. On heating, it decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the evolution of this carbon dioxide. When we heat this sodium hydrogen carbonate, sodium carbonate, water, and carbon dioxide is formed as CO3.
And carbon dioxide is
formed. Okay. Baking soda, it is otherwise known as sodium hydrogen carbonate. Its chemical formula is NaHCO3. The next one is the preparation of sodium hydrogen carbonate or this baking soda. Just the treating cold and concentrated solution of sodium chloride, that is NaCl, with ammonia and carbon dioxide. So the chemical reaction NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3 gives NH4Cl plus NaHCO3. Ammonium chloride plus sodium hydrogen carbonate. So on heating, it decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the evolution of carbon dioxide. So this NaHCO3, it will decompose to form Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2.
I'm on it, eh?
Rohan.
Yes, ma'am.
Please read the slide.
Baking soda. Chemical formula NHCO3.
Okay.
It is the produce on a large scale by treating cold and concentration solution of sodium chloride with the with ammonium and carbon
ammonia
dioxide.
Yeah.
NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3 NH4Cl plus NaHCO3.
Okay.
On heating it decomposed it decomposed to give sodium carbonate with the evolution of carbon dioxide.
Evolution of carbon dioxide. Right.
Yes. To NaHCO3. Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2.
Yeah. In this arrow, you can read as gives, okay? NaCO3 gives. Okay. Thank you, Rohan. Delvin? All of you, please switch on your videos. Delvin, can you please read the slide?
Yes, ma'am. Chemical formula NaHCO3. It is produced on a large scale by treating cold and concentrated solution of sodium chloride with ammonia and carbon dioxide.
Yeah.
NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3 gives NH4Cl plus NaHCO3.
Yeah.
On heating, it decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the evolution of carbon dioxide. 2NaHCO3 gives NH2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2.
Yes. This is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I move to next one? Uses of this baking soda. Okay. First one, used as an antacid to treat acidity of the stomach. We have learned about acidity, right? It's the excess production of hydrochloric acid in the stomach. So we can use this baking soda as an antacid to treat acidity of the stomach. So what's the nature of this sodium hydrogen carbonate? Basic, or they are alkaline in nature. That's why they can able to neutralize the excess acid produced in the stomach. Okay, that's the first point. Used as an antacid to treat acidity of the stomach. Due to their alkaline or basic nature, they can able to neutralize the excess amount of acid produced in the stomach. Then the second one, used to make baking powder, which is used in the preparation of cake, bread, etc. Okay. Used to make baking powder. So this baking soda, it is one of the component of this baking powder. It is used for the preparation of cakes, bread, etc. So in the case of this baking powder, it's a mixture of baking soda and tartaric acid. Okay. Baking soda plus tartaric acid. It's an edible one. Can you tell me the source of this tartaric acid? We have learned.
Turmeric.
Not turmeric.
Ma'am, first letter.
Yeah? Yeah, it's tamarind. Okay. Tamarind.
One minute.
Now, okay, I will show it once again. Just wait. Which acid is obtained from lemon, Revu? Lemon. What's the name of the acid?
Citric acid.
Okay, citric acid. So, Revu, you can tell me the acid obtained from curd. Curd. And you can tell me.
Yeah?
Yeah? Lactic acid. Then Ashik Joshi. Ashik.
Yes.
Please switch on your video, children. Yeah, Ashik, you can tell me the acid obtained from orange.
Citric acid.
Oh, citric acid. Good. Then Anandu, can you tell me the acid obtained from tomato?
I don't know.
Abin?
Yes, ma'am.
What's the name of the acid obtained from tomato?
Oxalic acid.
Oxalic acid. Then what about the acid obtained from tamarind? Mohammad Nihal, tamarind. That we discuss now, right? Yes, Swadi. Swadi.
Well.
Which acid is obtained from tamarind?
Tartaric acid.
Very good. It's tartaric acid. So here this baking powder, it's also a mixture of baking soda plus tartaric acid. Okay. It's a mixture of baking soda and tartaric acid. It's a mild edible acid. Okay. And the third use, it is used in soda acid fire extinguishers. Soda acid fire extinguishers. So these three are the important uses of this sodium hydrogen carbonate, or otherwise it is known as baking soda. Baking soda. Nasil, are you there? Can you please read the slide? Nasil. Yes. Unmute and read the slide, Nasil. Can you hear me? Shifana?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you please read?
Used as an antacid to treat acidity of the stomach. Used to make baking powder, which is used in preparation of cakes, breads, etc. Used in soda acid fire extinguishers.
Okay. Nesrin? Nesrin, are you there? Nesrin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, can you repeat this slide once again?
used as antacid to treat acidity of stomach, used to make baking soda, baking powder, which is used in preparation of cakes, bread, etc., used in soda acid for extinguisher.
Soda acid fire extinguishers. Okay. Then one more chemical reaction here. When baking powder is heated or mixed with water, when baking powder is heated or mixed with water. We can write that NaHCO3, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate plus one acid, right? All acids contain H plus ion. Here it is tartaric acid. In order to represent this acid, we are using this H plus ion. Okay, H plus ion. So it will react together to form CO2 plus H2O plus sodium salt. So these are the products when this baking powder is heated or mixed with water. And due to the production of this carbon dioxide, it will make the product very soft. Soft and spongy. You can write here. Due to the presence of CO2, cakes or bread very soft and spongy. Have you completed? How many of you like to bake cakes? Yes. Yeah, Raya, Shania, Adulya, Jesslyn. Suzanne, Gerlin. Only five. Chetra. Alna Rose. Yes. So this baking powder is a necessary ingredient, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next time you will bake cake, you should remember these points, okay? Due to the presence of this carbon dioxide in this baking powder, when it's mixed with water, carbon dioxide is produced. And due to the production of this carbon dioxide, it will make this cake very soft and spongy. Okay? Clear? Yes. So that's about baking soda. Then one more chemical from the common salt, it is known as washing soda. Pisan, it is not washing powder. It's washing soda. Washing soda. Its chemical formula, Na2CO3NH2O. Okay, Na2CO3NH2O. We have learned the same Na2CO3 in previous reaction. Do you remember that one? On heating sodium hydrogen carbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate on heating, it will decompose to this Na2CO3, right? So here, the preparation of this washing soda, the same reaction, sodium hydrogen carbonate on heating decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the release of hydrogen gas. Okay, sodium hydrogen carbonate on heating, that means baking soda on heating decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the release of hydrogen gas. You should write this 10H2O along with this Na2CO3. Okay. Recrystallization of sodium carbonate produces washing soda. So the recrystallization of sodium carbonate produces washing soda. So Na2CO3 is produced from the decomposition of sodium hydrogen carbonate. Then again, recrystallization of sodium carbonate will produce washing soda. So this is the chemical reaction. First one, NaCO3 on decomposition gives sodium carbonate plus H2O plus CO2. Then the sodium carbonate again reacts with water. That's the recrystallization. Okay. Again reacts with water to form Na2CO3 10H2O. Na2CO3 10H2O. So this is the preparation of washing soda. Its chemical formula Na2CO3 10H2O. Don't forget to write 10H2O. Minha, are you there? Minha?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you please read the slide?
Yes, washing soda, chemical formula, Na2CO3, 10H2O.
Yeah.
Sodium hydrogen carbonate on heating decomposes to give sodium carbonate with the release of hydrogen gas. Recrystallization of sodium carbonate produces washing soda. 2NaHCO3 gives Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2. Na2CO3 plus 10H2O gives Na2CO3 10H2O.
Okay. Have you completed? Yes, right? Yes. Then we are moving to the uses of this washing soda. Okay, uses of washing soda. First one, it is used in glass, soap, and paper industries. Okay, it is used in glass, soap, and paper industries. Employed in the manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax. Okay, it's a compound made up of the sodium. This is known as borax. So we are using this washing soda for the preparation of a compound known as borax. Sodium compound. And it is used as a cleaning agent for domestic purposes. We are using this washing soda for a cleaning agent in domestic purposes. And used for removing permanent hardness of water. What do you mean by permanent hardness? Hardness of water. Can you tell me? What is known as hardness of water? Any idea? Yeah, once again.
And density of the water.
Not the density of water. What's the property of such hard water? Yeah. Nothing. Okay, certain type of water molecules that in which the soap molecules do not dissolve. Okay, there are certain water in which soap molecules or the soap does not dissolve. It cannot able to produce foam. Such type of water is known as hard water. Okay, water in which soap does not dissolve and they cannot able to produce foam. Such water is known as hard water. So there are two types of hardness, temporary hardness, then permanent hardness. So when we are adding this washing soda into such water, it can able to remove the permanent hardness. Okay, clear? Hard water. Yeah, Lakshmi, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So in the case of this hard water, the soap does not dissolve and cannot able to produce foam. In order to remove this permanent hardness of water, we can able to add this washing soda. Yeah, Fizan, any doubt? Huh? I can't hear you. Not audible. Yeah, so this is the fourth use of this washing soda, used for removing permanent hardness of water. Sowell, can you please read the uses of washing soda?
Used in glass, soap and paper industries, employed in manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax, used as cleaning agents for domestic purpose, used for removing permanent hardness of water.
Okay. So these are the different uses of washing soda. Adulya, can you repeat the points once again?
Yes, ma'am. Used in glass, soap, and paper industries, employed in the manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax, used as a cleaning agent for domestic purposes, used for removing permanent hardness of water.
Yeah. Okay. This is clear? Yes, right? So we have completed this portion of chemicals from the common salt. Okay. So these are the different chemicals obtained from common salt. First one, NaOH, that is known as caustic soda. Second one, CaOCl2, it is known as bleaching powder. Then the third one, baking soda, it is NaHCO3. And the fourth one, Na2CO3 10H2O, that is washing soda. So these are the different chemicals obtained from common salt or sodium chloride. You have to learn the method of preparation and the uses, then common name, chemical formula, its chemical name. Okay? Common name, chemical formula, preparation, uses. Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there are certain questions based on this. I think we had discussed two questions from this page number 33, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then the third question, name the sodium compound which is used for softening hard water. Which compound is used for softening hard water? Yeah.
Washing soda.
Sodium carbonate. You can write washing soda in bracket, sodium carbonate, Na2CO3 10H2O. washing soda, sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, Pn2O. Saeed, can you read the next question? Fourth one, page number 33. Saeed, can you hear me? Isha, can you please read the fourth question?
What will happen if a solution of sodium hydrocarbonate is heated? Give the equation of the reaction involved.
Yeah, what will happen if a solution of sodium hydrocarbonate, similar to that of sodium hydrogen carbonate, okay? Sodium hydrocarbonate is heated. Can you tell me the product? If sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated, what will be formed?
Sodium carbonate.
Yeah, sodium carbonate. Then you can write the equation. NaHCO3 gives Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2. Okay, NaHCO3 gives Na2CO3 H2O plus CO2. Finished? All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let me take your attendance. Okay, just wait. Yes.
I'm Dominic, present.
Okay. Okay, thank you, children. See you in the next class. Okay. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.